In Sabah, Malaysia, palm oil plantations are a major contributor to state revenue with an area of approximately 1.5 million hectares. Based on data from the Consulate General of the Republic of Indonesia in Kota Kinabalu, there are almost 90% of palm oil plantations in Sabah which employ Indonesian migrant workers.
Let's meet the children of Indonesian migrant workers around palm oil plantations.
Mungkin Kelajar boleh berkenalan deh. Apa sih masalah yang kamu hadapi saat pandemi ini?
Terima kasih, Kak. Perkenalkan, nama saya Saslina binti Sulaiman, lahir dan tinggal di Sabah sudah 15 tahun. Masalah yang kami hadapi selama pandemi COVID-19 ini, terutama teman-teman di ladang, adalah listrik dan sinyal. Karena mulai tanggal 27 Juli 2020, kami mengikuti program PJJ SIKK kelas 10 MIA.
Kalau untuk sinyal mungkin bisa mencari spot tertentu ya. Tapi yang menarik masalah listrik ini seperti apa ya?
Kami sering kehabisan baterai ketika sedang belajar daring karena listrik di sini hanya bisa menyala sekitar pukul 6 sore sampai dengan pukul 10 malam. Karena itulah banyak tugas tidak selesai tepat waktu, Kak.
Genti Hajar juga berhasil mengunjungi salah satu perusahaan sawit loh. Di Sawit Kinabalu, Sendirian Berhad, Ladang Lumadan, Bufat, saya berhasil bertemu dengan Environmental Supervisor Puan Suzila. Bagaimanakah cara mengatasi limbah sawit di sini?
Kami di sini menggunakan sistem biological treatment, di mana kami hanya menggunakan bakteria lah untuk sistem rawatan.
Pertanyaan selanjutnya, berapakah limbah yang dihasilkan dari satu ton dan biaya yang dikeluarkan per bulan?
Limbah yang dihasilkan dalam 1 metric ton, di sini bergantung dengan keadaan buah lah. Sekiranya buah sedikit, penghasilan mungkin dalam 20%, dan sekiranya buah di sini banyak, maksimal 40% lah. Dan dari segi kos biaya, pemandangan kami menggunakan sistem bakteria biological treatment, kami tidak mengeluarkan apa-apa kos. Cuma dia punya kos penyelenggaraan bagi kolam, yaitu seperti macam membersihkan kolam, membersihkan rumput-rumput di dalam kolam, dengan kos upah pekerja mungkin dalam sekitar 4-6 K.
From the result of visit and interviews, we had the idea of an integrated project-based learning applying the concept of science, technology, engineering, and mathematics during the COVID-19 pandemic, namely the manufacture of palm batteries. This solution utilizes the waste of palm oil mill effluents to overcome the electrical limitations that long-distance education students experience in the palm oil mill effluents by applying the concept of volta cell, electricity, environment, linear programming, and battery technology with a simple approach to produce a palm battery. Palm batteries can be used by communities in Sabah, Malaysia, especially long-distance education students who are children of Indonesia migrant workers who work in palm oil plantations.
Some of the scientific concepts used to model the palm battery are the volta cell concept, the form of a copper metal circuit as a cathode on the positive pole and a magnesium band as an anode on the negative pole, coated with wet tissue as a salt bridge and a waste of foam as an electrolyte solvent. The circuit is also related to the electrical concept, namely the dynamic electricity concept, in which there are electric current, voltage, resistance, and electrical power produced from the foam battery model. The presence of electricity from the anode to the cathode can be tested using a multimeter. Meanwhile, according to biological studies, palm oil waste itself is waste that can pollute the environment if it is directly disposed into rivers. The effects of this waste are environmental pollution, death of organisms, and the damage of environment. The following are the content of the liquid waste.
wall clock, shelf and test tube, cables and crocodile clips, measuring pipettes, scissors, rulers, markers, and multimeters. Meanwhile, the materials are copper, magnesium, and wet tissue. The way to make it is, first, measure and cut 1 meter copper wire. Then, make a coil with the help of a marker to form a spiral. Next, measure and cut 17 cm of magnesium tape. Then, wrap it in a wet tissue. After that, put the tape that has been coated with the wet tissue into the copper metal spiral. This circuit is then inserted into the test tube. To do the test, lift the bio battery circuit, then add 40 ml of liquid waste into the test tube. The first test, which used one tube, from the observation results, it produced an electric voltage of 1.74 volts and electric current of 0.31 milliampere. Furthermore, the test was carried out with two tubes using the same method to increase the voltage. For the two tubes, the observation of the electric voltage is 3.25 volts and the electric current is 0.88 milliampere. The three tubes are 5.20 volts and the electric current is 1.80 milliampere. The four tubes produce an electric voltage of 6.65 volts and electric current of 2.40 milliampere. Then, 5 tubes produce an electric voltage of 8.75 volts and an electric current of 3.12 milliampere. Let's try using a wall clock. It turns out that the wall clock is on. Overall, the data obtained are: the result of all these trials are then graphed. The young scientists can use Microsoft Excel to make it easier to find equations for linear lines. From this data, the line equation y equals to 17.25x plus 1.85 is obtained. From the line equation, we can make the assumption that to produce a voltage of 220 volts on the x-axis, the volume of foam that must be prepared is 3.8 liters, or the equivalent of 127 foam battery tubes.
Well, young scientists, we can conclude that palm oil mill effluent can be used as an alternative electrical energy with the STEM-based science concept. Palm can also be used as an electrolyte solution in batteries with a certain electric voltage, which later can be stored in a power bank, and of course, can help distance education students. Young scientists,
develop a better world through science.